They'll come out throwing here on first down. And some room to maneuver. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one for Indianapolis resulting in 15 yards and a fresh set of downs. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there. Second down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Indianapolis right after this. A reminder coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before that. They go with the screen to Gore. Oh, and now he bowls him over, and he'll be out of bounds all the way down at the 5-yard line. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield. A really nice pickup.
He'll drop to throw. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. J.J. Watt in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year.
And that's the kind of stand all defenses are seeking. Third and goal, backs against the wall, and they get a monster sack, and now they're going to force him into a field goal. For them, that's a win.
And Vinatieri's kick is good. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now.
Let's face it, when Adam Vinatieri actually misses a field goal, that's when we're surprised. We're not as all shocked that he made this one.
Of course, he has the record 44 straight field goal makes. He closed out 2015 making 25 and then started 2016 with 19 in a row. And as this offense makes their way back out, NFC playoff race time, we give you a look at what's going on there. And it's all come down to this, hasn't it? Final week of the regular season. As this year's playoffs play out anything like the regular season has gone, could be in for a wild and fun month of January.
And we can break the rules because we can look ahead. All right, there's not a coach out there that's ever said to their team, all right, let's look three weeks down the road. It's always right here, right now. Forget that. Think about what the playoffs are going to look like. The teams that we see that are already in, the teams that are trying to get in, we could have some great matchups.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Griffin. He's going to float this over the middle deep. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
The best receivers we know always tease their quarterbacks to, hey, no matter what you do, you cannot overthrow me. Well, guess what? That's exactly what happened on that play. Normally, they time it up pretty well, but on that one, he just overshot him.
On second down, here's Griffin. And Miller with it over the middle. Say goodbye to Braxton Miller. Touchdown, Houston. Braxton Miller, an 80-yard touchdown. And the Texans are able to show off their quick strike ability. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Gets fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. So no update from Larry after 17 weeks. Folks are saying, let's get on with the show. So we'll oblige as we get you set for the second half kickoff. That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Out come the Colts. They'll have it first here to start quarter number three. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at six.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And that is incomplete.
Well, we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Taken in at the 22. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that fear.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Again, it's Miller. Miller with a first down and more. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. On first down, Griffin escaping the pressure right. And he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. And still for me, with the injuries, every time he carries that football, you just kind of hold your breath, don't you?
You have to, because you noted it. The injuries in the past have derailed his career up until this point. Now we're seeing some more evidence of him using his legs again, but he does have to be careful. They need him out on the field.
Yeah, RG3, you got to have him out there. So explosive.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
Second and 10 now. Griffin. Flushed out right. And some room to roam now. Dang. So here we go, first and 10 now. So RG3, you hate to see it again, forced from the ball game. And they will hand things over to their backup quarterback. Now it's the backup Watson, and shedding through the tackle. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Barkevious Mingo in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. And they brought the pressure there just right up the gut, didn't they?
Yeah, they certainly did. And, you know, when you've got so many different responsibilities as an offensive line, you got to deal with the nose tackle, the two defensive tackles or ends, and then sometimes you just can't account for everyone. The linebacker slipped free.
Now it's Watson, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. He has been interception prone here in his rookie season. How patient can they be with him?
That is the key question, isn't it? A lot of it depends on the head coach, what type of defense you have, and just a general understanding of the makeup of him. But the bottom line is, you posed a great question. Are they at the stage where they've run out of patience and now they get to demand production? Or do you continue to stay with him this way? I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. Now on second down, this is Gore. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
But he was stopped on that play. But he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
And he's got his man, Hilton. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
So if I'm an offensive coordinator, there's one thing that I know for sure. This is one of the top 5 teams in the NFL against the run. So when I look at my playlist, I'm probably thinking about throwing it.
Again, they run. Again, it's Gore. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature.
And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. If ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
So his 3rd field goal of the ball game brings him a bit closer, but there's no question. They need to start turning some of these 3s into 6s.
And 7s, and probably even 8s. You know, as a kicker, you just head out when you're called upon, so he's done his job. It's the rest of the offense that needs to get it in gear if they want to close this gap.
The Texans' offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done. Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
Now Griffin on 2nd down. What's coming, and down he goes. Barkevious Mingo in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Well, there was 2nd long, now it's 3rd and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here. Sports.